Hey YouTubians, it's Tony here from We Try Anything, Channel I Try Anything, so you don't have to. What we're going to have a look at today is yet another watch, and it's another Casio watch. Now, the reason why I've just kind of deluge of Casio watches is just that it's something quite interesting, and or something I do find quite interesting to have a look at on the channel. And a lot of people do enjoy looking at and using and wearing Casios, and it is a brand name that, you know, is synonymous with nostalgia, as well as kind of features and ease of use and just being a great watch in overall, really. So what we're going to have a look at today is the AE-1000W Casio watch. Now, this watch it's kind of in the budget range. It's a little bit more budget than the previous video that I've shown, which was a watch that which was the AE-3000. This one is more kind of akin to, you know, like your £20 range, which you'll find on Amazon and the likes, really. So no further ado, we're going to just open it, have a look around it, look at the design of it, and just show you some of the features and what we think. So just opening the watch, or just opening the actual box, you've got the usual Casio box here, and you have obviously the watch itself, which has got covered in kind of a like a plasticky bag, and also you've got the instructions as usual down the back of the watch, down the back of the watch box, as well as just the housing. So just chucking that to one side, and let's just get the Casio out the watch, the watch out the bag. And as you can see, it does have a bit of foam as well, just to protect the actual inner part of the case. And also, as you can see here it is. So here's the actual Casio AE-1000. Now, I'll just take off, there you go, that's off as well. So here it is in all its entirety, and as you can see, it is quite a good looking watch. Now, I'm going to be honest with you, I did open this up beforehand when I managed to get hold of it, and I've only recently got it literally the other day, just to complement the other watch that I got, which was the AE-3000. Now, this watch is way smaller than that. It's about the actual case width compared to the other one, which was about 55 millimeters, and this one is 43.7 to be exact. So as you can see, it is a lot smaller than the other. Now, just looking around the watch, as you can see, it has got a resin. It's got resin glass here. It's not kind of mineral or anything like that, or it isn't kind of normal glass. It is resin, so there's a good chance that it may scratch. Obviously, if you're going to use this watch for sort of heavy duty stuff, but people do tend to wear these watches for gardening and stuff like that, and kind of protect the more expensive watches. Because, I mean, obviously, as I say, they do have a price point of about £20. So, as I said, it's got a resin case to it. This bezel doesn't move or anything like that. Whoops, sorry. Also, the band is resin. Now, this came as a bit of, I mean, it is kind of, you know, I do like the kind of colour combination you've got going on here, which is kind of the lighter metal feel, which is obviously plastic. And also, you've got the buttons here, again, which are plastic as well. You know, they're not metal or anything like that. And also, well, it's quite nice that you've got the actual colour combination mirroring itself here, with the kind of a grey colour going here with the buttons, as well as the bezel, and also the actual strap. Now, coming onto the strap is resin as well. It's not like silicone or anything like that. And also, you do have your metal buckle going on here. Now, the only thing I did find was when I kind of picked it up and opened it for the first time, in comparison to the bigger watch, which was obviously half price, but is now back to normal price, which was about £50. This being 20, it does feel a little bit lower rent in the way, the quality. And I think that comes mainly from the strap. Now, the strap on here, it is resin, as I say, but it just feels a little bit less quality than some of the Casios I've handled. And it's such a shame for that, because I do like the look of the watch. I mean, obviously, you've got a very nice large LCD display, which is neatly designed, where this being the world timer watch, you have actually got like the, obviously the time here, which is the LCD display. You've got the date, the day, time, constant time here. Now, when I say constant time, when you go through the modes, this time will always display the local time, or local time one, because there is about 5 local times that you can choose. And also, you've got the world here, the map of the world here, where you can see what, you know, the time zone that you are in. Again, this is not GPS or anything like this. This is user set, as it were. And also, it does have what the other watch had, which was daylight saving, which you can turn on and off, which just slightly affects the other time zones by adding and minusing an hour as such. Also, you do have the little display up here, which says if you've got an alarm, if you've got the phone on mute, if you've got the watch on mute, and any other kind of, you know, as I say, got alarms and stuff like that. But as I say, just kind of around the back, obviously you got your back plate there, which I believe is stainless steel. It's a very nice looking watch. I do like the look of it, as it were, and especially like the color combination that is going on here. And you can get this watch in kind of an orange, and I believe you do, like where the strap's orange and the bezel's black and stuff like that. And also, yeah, I believe you can get it in a gold color, which is a lot more expensive, but this one being the cheaper one, you know, it doesn't look too bad. But as I say, the resin band is the only place where it kind of falls short, really. And the reason being, it's not as comfortable as the other watches to wear, and there's I didn't find as much kind of give. Now, I'm going to quickly go through what the little features of the watch, and then I'll just highlight a little bit more on this resin band when I put it on my arm. So just looking through the features of the, as I said, you've got all your kind of display going in here, which I've explained. You do have a light here, which if I can just, I'll turn off the main light just to show you the actual light of what's going on here. So main light off. And if I can just pop my hand over there and just kind of show the time and stuff like that. But I don't think it's kind of in the terms of showing you the whole display perfectly. So if you're after something like that, then you may have to look elsewhere. But you just got to remember the price point that this watch is at. It is at the kind of £20 price mark, really. So the other functions that this watch has is it has where you can choose the different world times that you can change. So obviously, you know, there's all forms of time zones and stuff like that. I'm trying to find one that I recognise, to be honest. I believe that might be Delhi, Bangkok and the likes. It also has five alarms that you can change, which you can just press by changing and adjusting and stuff like that. Now, as I say, I'm not going to really highlight, I'm not going to go too in depth with these in this review, because I mean, at the end of the day, there's plenty of other reviews of this watch, but I just wanted to give you my opinion on it. Timer, which I believe is a 24-hour timer, which can count down in measuring units of a tenth of a second, which is interesting. Also, there is a stopwatch, and goes back to your main kind of time zone here, or your main display. Now, anything, I don't know if you've noticed that, but any option that you choose, or any kind of time zone that you change to and stuff like that, you will notice that that is your constant display here, that like kind of what would be like an analog look to the watch. So you've got an idea of what kind of time zone you are in, but obviously you could kind of look at other time zones that are going on. It does have five alarms, which I've mentioned as well. Back to the timer, but I'm just kind of showing that that doesn't change, and there you go. This does have a 10-year battery as well, which can deplete if obviously you start to use the kind of light a lot and stuff like that, and the features that the watch has. And also, as it says there, it is water resistant to 100 meters, which is another great option with this watch. So you can go swimming in it, you can do obviously go for a shower or wash your hands and stuff like that, and it will resist the water up to a depth of 100 meters. The other thing as well, it has an auto calendar, which once you have set the calendar, it'll automatically display the correct date as well, which is good. I mean, obviously we're on the 23rd of June and it's a Wednesday, so yeah, it's working well. How does it look on the wrist? Now, I'm just going to pop it on the wrist to give you an idea. It is quite comfortable, not brilliant, but because it was hurting a little there, but for some reason, I mean, after just a little bit of shaping, it seems to have kind of worked its magic. It is a nice looking watch, and it fits the hand well. I mean, if I can move that up a little, it does a little bit dig into there, but I'm so used to this watch now being of a square shape, then obviously anything circular will kind of just dig into there a little, but nowhere near as as much as the other watch did, because that did really kind of go here. But for your £20, I mean, I don't know, there's a lot of watches at that price point on the likes of Amazon and stuff like that. And I mean, it does have a lot of, it's got a very good looking design to it. There's nothing bulging out, or there's nothing kind of taking your eye away from the main time. And with it being a world timer, obviously you can go into different time zones and stuff like that, or when you're traveling into different countries. And, you know, this being like a very cheap watch, you know, you wouldn't be worrying about people trying to nick it or anything like that. But in terms of how it looks and how it sits on your wrist, yeah, it's nice. The only thing I will say, it does pinch a little here. Now, that is probably more down to where it's trying to kind of grip on your wrist here. And I do find that it does kind of just pinch in a little. Now, I don't know if this is obviously because it's brand new and that kind of needs to just, you know, like get a bit more, be a little bit more flexible in the way it sits on your hand. But on your wrist. But it does kind of pinch there as well. So not so much pinch, but kind of pull in a little where you can feel that this watch is on your hand. So just bear that in mind. It's not as comfortable as, say, some of the other watches I've featured on the channel. But, you know, it might be a watch that you get used to, or it may be a watch that, you know, it's just something for, you know, not so much daily wear. Well, daily wear, I mean, obviously these are at a price point where they are good for daily wear. But it might be something where, you know, I don't know, it's just gardening and stuff like that it'd be good for. But in all, it is a good looking watch. The only thing, as I say, that lets it down is it's just that strap. It's just a little bit pinchy, like kind of pinchy there. But that may be on my wrist, and it may be a bit different on other people's wrists. But otherwise, yeah, I would say if you are looking for something like this in this kind of price point, then, you know, give that one of your considerations, because it is definitely a nice watch to look at. Some nice feature set. It's obviously got an illuminated light on there as well, with 5 daily alarms. It'll do 4 time zones to display that you can cycle between. And, you know, what more do you want? It's got a stopwatch and a timer. You know, if you're after a simple watch that's got a few functions, then definitely consider this one. You know, it's well worth looking at. So we hope you like the video. And if you've got any, if you do own this watch, then please pop in your comments in the comment section below and tell me what you think about it. You know, thank you for watching. And if you do like the video, give it a cheeky like and subscribe. There will be more reviews coming soon. And thank you for watching. And we look forward to seeing you next video. Goodbye.